Rate limiting is an important feature that you need in production applications. It sounds scary, but it's actually fairly easy to implement rate limiter in today's world. So today we're going to implement a rate limiter using Upstash. Now, if you don't know what Upstash is, it's serverless data that can be served to you on the edge using Redis or Qstash. I prefer Redis, most people do, and it has a really good free tier. So we're going to use this to implement rate limiting because they have a rate limit package. Makes it dead simple to implement anywhere that you're using APIs. So first you need to sign up for an account. Once you've done that, you'll click your console here. You'll be dropped into this page here where you click create database. Now you can give it a name. We're just going to call this rate limit. And then you're going to set the region to the correct region for your area. So if you're in US East 1 or if you're in West, etc. So for me, I am in East 1. And you can enable TLS if you want. So let's go ahead and create our Redis for Upstash. Now that's created, we're going to need this .env right here. So if you click this button, it's going to show you your Redis REST URL and the token that you're going to need. So we can copy those and we can drop them right in our .env. So for now, we're done here. We don't actually need to do anything else to set this up. So from here, we're going to go to our IDE, and I am using Zed for this. Check out a video coming real soon. And we're going to add a .env here. And right now I have clerk and I have a database URL. Now we can add Upstash here. We'll just drop these two Upstash URLs in here and the token, and we can close this out. So if you've never seen clerk before, it's user authentication and management for the modern web. Next.js, Remix, Gatsby, etc., etc., etc. And I've just have this implemented as a T3 repo, which you can check in the description. Essentially, what we do here is we wrap our application up and we just make sure they're signed in and signed out. Now, if you've seen TRPC before, there's a thing called protected procedures, and we're going to quickly look at those as well. So inside of our APIs here, we have this root, which has our routers here, and then this TRPC section, which contains something called is authed. And what we're doing here is checking to see if the user has an auth session and then if they have a user ID, which comes from our context here. What we're just checking here is to make sure they have a user ID. If they don't have a user ID, they clearly can't be logged in. So we'll just set unauthorized. And then the context itself, all we're doing is just retrieving the auth context right using get auth here. This get auth feature allows you to grab things such as user ID, session ID, things that you may need for data loading, such as getting a JWT token, things like that. So that's basically everything. I don't need to go too far into this. If you want to see videos, I've done plenty of them. Just check them out. They're in my YouTube playlists. So we want to implement a way to rate limit a particular router. So in our example router, we have two right now, get all and then hello. So we're going to create a new one here called expensive. Now this expensive procedure here is going to be a protected procedure, which we need to import. And we're just going to have a query here. And all we're going to do is pass in context. And then we're going to return something. We'll just return expensive. And then we'll close this out. And what we're going to do is use the context to grab the user ID to use that as part of our rate limit. So now we have this expensive procedure and the user must be logged in. We can now start creating our rate limiting. So we need to install two packages here, one called the Upstash rate limit. And then the second one is the Redis package as well that comes from Upstash. So we need to install those. So it's npm install at upstash slash rate limit, all one word, and then upstash redis. So we're going to let those install and then we can create our rate limiting procedure. To do this, we just need to import rate limit, and that comes from upstash. And then we're going to also import redis. So now we have our two imports here, and the squiggly lines is just to tell me that we haven't actually implemented anything with these yet. So let's start using them to create a rate limit that says, hey, if they've done X and Y, stop them and we'll throw a 429. So We do const here and we'll call it rate limiting or rate limiter equals new rate limit. And then inside the rate limit, we need two things here. We need to tell it what Redis that we're using and then the limit that we're using. So you do Redis dot from env, and that will give us our Redis that we're using in our .env. So we'll know which one we're using. And then we need our limit here. So we do limiter. And then essentially what we do with limiter is tell it how many times someone can make a request in how many seconds. So you could do 60 in 60 seconds, 1 in 5 seconds, whatever it might be. So we use rate limit dot sliding window. So that gives you a sliding window of how many times they can do it. And then we can set it to how many requests. So I'm going to do 3 requests in, and then we'll just set this to 5s. So that's they can do up to 3 requests in 5 seconds before we start rate limiting them. Hit save. And now our rate limiter is complete. And now we can implement this anywhere that we want. So a rate limiter requires two things. It requires some sort of identifier to identify that the user is indeed the same user making these multiple requests. Now this can be anything from a user ID to an IP address, depending on how you want to implement it. We're going to use user ID because we have access to that and it's very easy to implement. Of course, you can use whatever kind of identifier you may need. So now we have this expensive procedure, we can basically create what we need. So we can do const and then success equals and then rate limiter dot limit. And then we tell it what we need to limit. So we're going to do context.auth.userid. And that is the user ID of the user. And I need to learn how to spell success. And now we have this success here. We need to throw an await here. And then we need to also make sure this is asynchronous. So it's going to complain. And we just need to add our async here. All right. So now we have success. We can say if not success. So if there is no success here, we need to throw some sort of error messages. Now TRPC is great at this, so we can do TRPC error and import that from server. So we can do throw new TRPC error, and then we need code. And the code that we're going to use is too many requests. So too many requests, which is essentially rate limit, and then we are good to go. So now we have that, we have this protected procedure. Now we should use this protected procedure somewhere in our application. Now I happen to have this protected route right here, and this protected route doesn't have any TRPC on it right now. So we can actually just grab this example hello, and we can just change it to something else. So we can say, add the import here, and now we can use example, expensive use query, and we don't need anything in here, and we can hit save. And we're not using this, which is fine, but we can essentially use this page to fire off as many requests as we need. So if we hit save here and we run npm run dev and we go to our localhost 3000 and we open up our space here, right now it just says click here to protect procedure. So let's click the button. And then let's go ahead and log in with Google, and we'll just select me. And now we just wait till we get redirected back to this protected page. And here we go. So if I go to my console right now, you can see this is fine. But if I hit refresh, so now we've hit refresh, you can see that we're now getting a 429 too many requests. And now if we wait a few seconds here and then we hit refresh, we should get a result here for our first request. Now, the reason it's popping off so much is because I've set it to 1 and 1 to make sure it works. So we can say 5 requests in 1 second. And if we refresh now, you can see that every time we hit, it goes through. So there you have it, a way to implement rate limiting as quickly as possible. Now, if you did enjoy this video, make sure that you click this button right here. It will show you a video that is driven by the algorithm. And of course, hit subscribe if you're not already.